Welcome to Voris CLC's Black History Month interview series. My name is Kendall and I am a fourth grader here at Voris CLC. My guest today is Mr. Delone Carter. He is a former NFL player for the Indianapolis Colts. After his football career, he has worked as a police officer and a private trainer. Mr. Delone Carter, I want to welcome you today.
Kendall, thanks for having me, man. It's awesome for you to have me here. I'm very excited for you to do this interview with me.
And I have a few questions for you. What does Black History Month mean to you?
It's a great question. What does Black History Month mean to me? It's a sense of pride for my culture and my history, past, present, and future. It's something that's, you know, being added to on a daily basis. You know, it's just about striving for greatness and persevering through all obstacles when all odds are against you.
That's really interesting. Who is a person that we may not have heard of that inspires you?
That's a good question, man. It's just hard to name one person. It starts in my household with my mother, her mother, my great-grandparents, my father, my uncles. So I'm seeing Black history made by them on a daily basis, as well as myself. But some names that you might be familiar with is like Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Muhammad Ali, Rosa Parks, Aretha Franklin, a great singer, Sam Cooke. You know, he made a profound song, Change Is Gonna Come. It's very inspirational and very motivating, not just to our cultures, but anybody that's going through any hardship. Sidney Poitier, a great actor, Jesse Owens, but somebody you probably haven't heard of. I just seen something on social media. I follow this page. His name is Jeremiah Harlison. He was born in April 1st, 1848. A little bit about him. He was enslaved by a Georgia plantation owner named John Harlison. So as you can see, after slavery, you know, African-American people had to take their slave owners' names. So that's why it's important to do a deep dive into your history and see where you come from, you know, in Africa as well. But a little bit more about Harlison. He was enslaved from 1848 to 1865. So that's 19 years. During that time, he taught himself how to read and write, and he became a debater. In 1868, he made an attempt for a seat at Congress. It was the 41st Congress seat that he was attempting for in Alabama, first district, and he failed, of course. You know, all odds were against him, but he persevered through it 2 years later to gain that seat. So, you know, people like that, to know that we've been overcoming adversity since 1800s, is just very inspirational to me. Another guy you might not know too much about is Fred Hampton. He was part of the Black Panther Party, which was in the media portrayed as a violent party, but really when you do a deep dive into the history of it, they were more about health clinics and education than the self-defense. But you know, they did defend themselves, you know, through racism and bigotry. But the gist of it was healthcare and education and community. So that's another guy as well. So it's just on multiple cases like that inspired me.
Thank you for sharing. What is the best way for our students to celebrate Black History Month?
Your best way to celebrate Black History Month, being in the fourth grade, what you should do is be inspired and be inquisitive and ask questions of your elders. And, you know, lean on everybody around you, because that's what you're supposed to do at this time, be a sponge. Soak up, have a big perspective, learn other cultures and their adversities as well, and understand with persistence and perseverance, you're capable of anything. Nothing can hold you back.
Thank you for sharing your inspiration and your experience with us, Mr. Delone Carter. This has been Kendall for Voris CLC.
Thanks for having me, man. Oh,